Anyway, we have another caller on the line. Dennis Mojano from Quezon City. Let's put him on. Hello?
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 Good morning, Dennis.
Good morning, Nicole and Attorney Nikki.
Yes, good morning.
I enjoyed the show.
Oh, thank
kasi
you.
Actually, nakikinig ako. Ako, ingay ng aso.
Okay lang. Hi din sa aso mo.
Oo, hello.
Yung maliit na cute na aso.
Oh, okay. Mm-mm.
Yeah. You know, yung Shih Tzu'ng malago ang buhok, may makita yung mata.
Ah, oh, Shih Tzu. Oh. Oh, okay. Anong pangalan ng aso mo, Dennis?
Kuku.
Kuku?
And Mix. Dalawa.
Oh, that's sweet.
Baka gusto rin magsalita ng aso mo sa radyo.
Kasi, sabihin ko lang, I enjoy the program, clarity of the program. Of course, the gorgeous voice of Attorney Nikki, although hindi ko pa siya nakikita.
Ah, talaga.
Nakita ko na si Nicole sa Sunday Jam several months ago.
That was not me. Dalo ko lang.
The
I only came out once. Nakita mo. Si Attorney Nikki is gorgeous. I'll tell you.
And of course, Nicole is a great looking.
Nax!
Mistisa si Nicole eh.
No,
I like her sweetie style. No? His jokes.
Oh.
Funny. But of course, her no nonsense. Ano? Approach to every issues.
Okay.
And of course, the Attorney Nikki, not only her... Of course, she's an attorney at law, but doesn't only tackle in legal matters, but also yung business na.
Yes.
Naku, lumalaki na ulo ko niyan. Dennis, tama na.
Yeah.
Thank you for your compliment.
Thank you very much, Dennis.
Yeah, yeah. Can I have some comments?
Yeah, sure.
Go ahead.
I think in our place, in Commonwealth, there are areas here, kumbaga eyesore, kumbaga parang mga shanties, no? So-called squatters areas, farmaceuters. Why the government, city government oblige us, taxpayers resident, to pay for higher tax just for the housing of these so-called informal settlers, our kambayan, di ba? Sila naman, actually, they can avail, eh. May mga ano sila, livelihood, may mga Coco Lumber store, may mga junk shop.
So, ang yaman na pa.
Why not na, di ba?
Why do they have to tax us?
To our national government, is it national government na may projects na ganyan, mga local housing, di ba? And I think this prime lot, located near to us in Commonwealth, kasi it's real eyesore, squatter looking, shanties. I think the properties they occupied now, whether it is government or private property, can develop into a commercial area.
Yeah, that's true. You're right.
Saka, wag nang magkaroon ng kaso na bloody demolition. No?
That always happens in Quezon City kasi.
I think it's a problem po, no? A mistake. Kung may political will siya, saka national government, of course, which ako, supporter ni Pinoy, pero parang disgusted ako. Really.
Thank you, Dennis. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, we receive very interesting comments. So just to interject, Nicole, I recall, no, isa kong empleyado taga Quezon City. Nagre-reklamo siya kasi sabi niya, ako nga, walang bahay.
Oo.
Tapos, I have to pay so that other people can have houses. The government does not pay for my rent. Ako na mo problema, maghahagilap ng pangbayad ng renta. Pero ngayon, hihingan tayo ng pera ng gobyerno para magkaroon ng bahay ang ibang tao.
They,
absurd,
di ba? They raise the taxes, you know? I mean, your employee, for example, is renting and then they raise the taxes, magbabayad pa siya for other people to live there. I'll say one thing though, ha? Sometimes, sasakalin na ako ng mga barangay captain at saka counselor dyan sa Quezon City, pero sometimes, they like bringing in informal settlers or squatters, these politicians, because they add to more votes on the local level, sa local government. Oh, pero may tumawag na. So,
okay. We have June Mandap from Paranaque on the line. Let's put him on. Hello, June?
Hello.
Yes.
Hello, June.
Good morning.
Both of you.
Good morning.
What program is this? Mind your own business.
Yes, okay, yes.
Okay. When I have to, something to add to your insight. Example, no, when I remember when I was a student before, no, walking when I passed by through Recto and so, you know, sometimes making business, you know, it's too hard, you know, because example, sometimes you do the ethics, you know, business ethics, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Example, you pass by kasi yung mga business nung araw, no, yung example, yung mga vendor, pag mani yung isa, yung peanut, ano, mani na lahat yun. Yun lang doon, ano. Sometimes, talagang, ano, talagang, hindi mo alam kung iniinsulto yun, ano. And of course, Nicole is right, no. Aside from the peace and order, you find it hard to, ano, no, example, when you, file a business permit, no?
Mm-hmm.
There is a too much process, no?
Mm-hmm.
From the building plans, estimates, specifications, and so on and so on. Then you go to the department, no?
Mm-hmm.
Example, from civil, architectural, electrical,
fire, yahat yan.
So the government should limit the process of doing this, no? Example, right now, I think in Paranaque, no?
Mm-hmm.
Medyo, ano eh, medyo wala na nag-ano ng business, ano?
Mm-hmm.
How do you call this? Parang nire-refile nila, no? Yung business permit, ayaw na yun, specifically. Lalo-lalo na yung mga foreigner, ano? Nandito, yung making, ano, no? Small business here.
Mm-hmm.
They find it hard kasi nga itong mga requirement, no, especially sa mga taxation, so medyo mahirap.
Mm-hmm.
So yun lang, no, yun lang siguro ang may contribute natin sa, no, sa insight na inano ni ano ni Nicole.
Okay.
Thank you very much, June. Okay, very interesting comments from people, and I understand where June is coming from, kasi one turn off for an entrepreneur would be very onerous government requirements and also licenses. Diba sabi ko nga sa isa Pasig, absurd. Do you know they would require you, yung mga employees mo, to submit x-ray tsaka drug test bago ka bigyan ng permit. Diba? Hindi, I'm just saying,
no,
of
it's
course,
true. But you have to pay for that,
yes,
Nikki. X-ray is about 300 to 350 if it's a normal, and then drug test, I don't know how much that is.
It should, ang hirap kasi, no, it's not that I'm espousing a laissez-faire government, but the government should take a hands off some matters which should be private. Say for example, in my business, I don't like drug addicts, pero naman don't compel me na bago mo ako bigyan ng permit kailangan yung mga empleyado ko umihi muna, and then magpa-x-ray. It's such a hassle, you know, parang madidisrupt ang isang buong workday namin because of that, because I have to send them, oh sorry, you have to go there, get your
hindi
X-ray,
lang isa siguro. More than one
your
day,
employees.
Two or three days, because you go there now and then they'll come back with a result later pa and whatever, then before they give you the permit. That's stupid.
Ang kumikita kasi yung mga laboratory.
Oo, yun.
Yan ang problema
actually,
sa atin.
Actually, si Dennis mentioned that, crime lab pala yung sinabi niya. Then, you know, yeah, exactly. And I forgot to ask June from Paranaque if the foreigners there were mostly, he said they were putting up small businesses, they were getting turned off. If they were, I heard there are a lot of nice restaurants in Paranaque, so I was wondering if that was the kind of business they were putting up. I can just imagine what they have to go through. They need, some safety standard or health standard, and they're like, what are you talking about? There's roaches all over the place.
Alam mo, kaya gusto ko magnegosyo sa Mandaluyong. Not that I'm really espousing it, but I've tasted it firsthand. And I've also spoken to the government officials. Talaga ang bilis kumuha ng permit.
Yes.
Because I think there is a measure adopted by the LGUs. No?
They're very reasonable in Mandaluyong, I think.
Kaya siguro ganun, kasi the present mayor, Abalos, is the one who spearheaded the streamlining of the business permit system, na ang proposal nila is to shorten it, cut the bureaucracy. Halimbawa, let's say kung yung mga compliance sa building, fire, pwedeng to follow, i-grant mo na lang to follow na lang yung compliance. Oo. Parang may mga ganong systems in place.
And then if you never follow up, then it gets revoked. Ganun na lang. The tendency will really be for you to follow up so you can get it as a permanent thing.
Kasi, you know, in a city, I won't say the name, grabe, you know, it took us 2 months to get the business permit. Grabe, kasi ganun katagal, ang dami pa, and you have to wait for inspection, isi-schedule, and how many thousands of businesses are existing in that place? So, at the mercy ka ng inspector. So, tatawag ka sa inspector, paki-prioritize. Anong
parang,
kapalit nun?
Parang naiinis pa siya sa'yo kasi you're making kulit. Well, there's only one inspector and how many thousands of
kaya
businesses.
Nga. So, he must be a very rich inspector.
You know, I remember there was a bill proposed. I mean, there have been different bills proposed in Congress, in the lower house. There was one proposed, like, for example, by then Congresswoman Villar, like simplifying the, mm-hmm. the procedures. I actually don't know if they
yung
passed it or whatever.
Not.
The thing is, even if they pass that, sometimes it's up to the local government to enforce it.
Yes.
But it always starts with good laws. That's why it's good to have good legislators in Congress and in the Senate. Diba?
Go siguro ahead. Bottom line, no, Nicole, nasa tao. You
nasa
elect
tao.
Good officials.
Elect good officials. And then pagdating sa local government ninyo, the mayors and all the way up to the governor,
yung
elect good officials.
Kasi,
pati yung barangay captain ninyo, Diyos ko.
Oh, wag yung kung sino-sino.
Wag kayong magpapadala sa papa, inumin lang kayo.
Katapat ng isang gin.
Oo, or ano ba yung mahilig na yung brandy na, ano yun?
Emperador?
Marano, ganun.
Emperador,
dapat i-sponsor mo na.
I-sponsor ang official drink ng
actually,
mga
actually, masarap yun.
Ihalik
one ko na rin.
Anyway, you know, Nicole is already 12 o'clock. Ay, you know, time flies by so fast when you're having fun. And we really enjoy the comments from our listeners. Siguro, you know, the same way you missed us, we missed you as well. No?
Really
the
missed you. And so glad to hear from today from Dennis, Mang Hernan, June, and JV of Pasig. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you know, really, the goal of our show is not only to make you laugh, to educate you, but also to make you think and make you act. No? Kasi we will tell you what are your rights, what you can do. You know, at sometimes we will give you our opinion. Mm-hmm. So, ikaw na bahala magtahi-tahi, no?
Oh, and you are also welcome to give us your opinion. Because other people will listen to you and they'll be like, yeah, that's right.
Tama.
Yeah,
exactly. Diba? Yeah. Anyway, so, thanks for a good show, Nicole, as
thank
usual.
Thank you, Nikki. So, we'll see you guys again next week on Wednesday. Because Mondays and Fridays now are for other shows also to give you more of a balance. But we love being here. And we're friends with them. So, don't worry. You're friends with the other shows on Mondays and Fridays as well. Everyone here is friends.
Okay. So anyway, stay tuned for Jerry Cornejo for Not Necessarily the News. This has been Mind Your Own Business on DZRJ 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines.
You have been listening to